With the release of the new M1 Max, the most common question everyone seems to ask in social media, in YouTube comments, is this: 8GB of memory RAM or 16GB? This video will give you an idea of whether you should buy the 8GB or 16GB version of the Mac Mini, MacBook Air or MacBook Pro with M1 chips you are interested to purchase. To give a straight answer right at the beginning of the video, if you're a basic user who just surfs on the internet, watch some Netflix movies, learn new things or entertain yourself on YouTube, write documents, edit some photos and making some videos, even 4K ones, then the 8GB version will be more than enough, without meaning that this basic 8GB version cannot handle more complicated tasks as well. You can check my previous video on editing in Final Cut Pro, 4K video, with files from the Sony A7S III that is popping right now on the top right corner, and check its performance. Now, to answer the question in a more depth look, let's start from the unified memory. I don't know if you have noticed, but next to the 8GB and 16GB, you see a unified memory. Machines with discrete GPU have separate memory for the CPU and GPU. The new Apple Silicon Max combine all these components into a single system on a chip. Building everything into one chip gives the system a unified memory architecture. This means that the GPU and CPU are working over the same memory. But what about swap memory now? If we take a look at the activity monitor while we're working on this M1 Mac Mini 8GB, you will see that it says physical memory 8GB, memory used 6.57GB and swap used 1.72. Swap memory takes place when you overload your RAM. If you start to maximize the use of the memory of your new Mac, will overflow into swap memory, which uses the SSD to store data that should have been stored in your RAM in the first place. But in RAM, which stands for Random Access Memory, you can't store files to it. In SSD, you can write and remove files. That means files and data are constantly written and erased on the SSD that usually wouldn't. If you do this over and over again, that means that there is a possibility over the years the SSD will become slower. Yet on the SSDs, this might take a lot of years before happening. My opinion on the swap memory is very simple. All modern SSDs are rated for a long lifetime of reads and writes and do not wear down as easily as they used to back in the day. We need to add a note here and say that SSDs start to slow down as you fill them up with files. That means that another good question would be 256GB or 512 storage option for future proof of use and performance, since the performance will be better with more free storage available. Some people say that if you want to use the Mac for many years, 16GB of RAM would be beneficial. Let's analyze this a little bit further and tell you what I think. Right now, almost all the third-party apps are not compatible with the M1 chips, and they run via Rosetta 2 code, something like a virtual environment. With Rosetta 2, we can't have the full performance from the M1 chip, and this is something pretty normal. The M1 Macs are revolutionary devices that, as we all can understand, will take a lot of time for applications to use every megabyte of its new architecture to benefit from them. So for future proof, I would say that it depends on how you're going to use these new Macs. Since after 6 or 12 months, when all the applications and third-party plugins will be M1 compatible, we can predict what the performance is going to be. And also how you're going to use your new M1 Mac will be the primary reason for your decision to go for 8GB or 16GB version. If you're a creator who creates plenty of 4K or even higher content daily, render a lot of files, use Photoshop and Lightroom in a more extreme mode, and you enjoy multitasking, then you will definitely see an improvement with the 16GB. My friends Patrick Tommaso and Liz Avitz, who have the 16GB version, can confirm that the performance on this is amazing, even on heavy tasks. Go check their videos, by the way, after you finish watching this, from the links in the description. If you want the best performance available and your budget allows it, then you would definitely benefit from the combination of the 16GB of memory RAM and 512GB of SSD storage for more demanding tasks. More memory for swap usage and more storage available for SSD performance. If you're a basic user, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, 8GB will be more than enough. And again, that doesn't mean that with the 8GB you won't be able to edit videos, photos and do multitasking. Actually, this is one of the main reasons why I picked the 8GB. And by saying this, if you are interested in the new M1 systems, make sure to subscribe for more videos, especially related with video editing programs like Final Cut Pro and M1s. If you have any questions or anything that you want to see on a future video, please place them in the comments down below. As always, thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video.